When you talk about ETs harvesting our energy as Loosh, can we ever run out of energy?
No, we don't. I mean, you can get so breed up and burn out that you're, you know, you're like smoking ashes there on the field. But you know, there's still, you still got your juice there. Yeah. It's not like you're going to run out and they're going to leave you alone. Not like, it doesn't work that way. Yeah. Not in my understanding of it.
All right.
What gives a person energy? We create the energy. We're the energy generators. And it's by what we think. We create energy by what we're thinking. Our thinking itself is energy created. When you imagine a beautiful rose garden, you literally, with your thoughts, you generated energy. You've manifested energy in the form of a beautiful rose garden, and it radiates energy off of it. This is you having generated the energy. So your very thoughts are creating the energy. If you're afraid of something and you have a scary thought and you see scary things, you are creating that with your own ability to be the creator of all things. Energy put into form to create more density energy, the more it becomes matter instead of energy. In form, you see the appearance of the energy in that form. You did that with your thoughts. And if you don't do it consciously with your thoughts, you can trigger stuff that you've put in your data banks or your subconscious mind, and that energy is stored there as potential energy. You tap it and it kind of comes out, and it, you know, explodes into this vision. But when you unremember it, the energy that is turned into a 3D holographic visual image memory, you stop thinking about it, focusing on it, you stop giving it that conscious energy, it starts, and it stops being the thing, and it becomes back to the potential. It's got like code, it's got a label on it, you know. And you know, you've got, you know, autorun.exe, you click that, or setup.exe, and it explodes into your 2D monitor. Well, think of it as 3D. It explodes. It's just code, but now it explodes into a 3D experience. And it's either in 3D in virtual world or 3D in this physical simulation or virtual world. Very similar in that way. So we don't really run out of it. We might stop thinking and stop manifesting or creating that energy phenomena. Then when that happens, you're going to end up with quiet mind and just be here now, and it's going to be this sense of the void, emptiness, no energy, no space. I mean, no energy and no matter within the space. And then when you don't have the energy cluttering up your space, it's not so much you ran out of energy, you just stop cranking it out on automatic all the time. Quiet mind. Meditation. Then you're able to know more because your attention isn't focused. You know, if your attention is totally focused on the rabbit in the garden, there could be a bird over here, two birds fighting it out or tweeting or doing something. You are so focused on this, you're not aware or conscious of this. So when you're thinking things, you're aware and conscious of what you're thinking about. And all that stuff you could be aware of and could be conscious of, you're not. Because you're thinking, you're who am I? Why am I here? why is that car driving so fast? You know, we just, if you quiet the mind and go, knowingness will come to you. You will expand your knowing and consciousness, and you start knowing stuff, and you're becoming one. All that is, because that's consciousness. Ooh.